maybe you know or you don't know that UNITED has focused on pediatric formulation and diagnostic since day one, since 10 years ago. We have been following closely, in fact, the opportunities in terms of pediatric, together in close relationship with WHO through the pre-qualification or essential medicine list. But I think we have been working also on that very closely with the Global Fund since day one. It was not easy sometimes, because what is happening in the country is the most important. And at the time, we had an issue in terms of forecast, in terms of epidemiology, so that you have mentioned. But I think that to make the link with the initial presentation, I think that if we are serious about universal coverage, I think we need to think about three things that you mentioned. First, the money. So the money has to come also from the country and domestic money, and I think that we can praise you for the decision you made in Zambia, for sure. The second is, of course, human resources, and you mentioned that also. But in fact, it's linked with the access of medicine of test. And what we see as UNITED is also the efficiency that access to better adapted medicine can bring to the system, because it's easy to use for the, in this case, the children, but for the caregivers, the mothers, or even to be sick, should not be a full-time job, in a way. And that's the situation we see when the product are not adapted. But what I want to highlight, in fact, is the model we have. And I want to highlight during the portfolio. The portfolio is something for UNITED, but I think that what we want to reach is the scale-up. This is a situation we are facing for several products that we have been investing with the partner as DNDi, as, of course, MMV and TB Alliance. So, of course, the kind of innovation at the beginning, it's exactly what we have described before, the very specific challenge for the pediatric formulation, for all the reasons you know, but I will put in addition the fact that there are very specific markets that are small volumes compared to the adult, for sure. Also, in some cases, it's shrinking. Fortunately, there is less children now living with HIV because of the success of PDMTCT. So, of course, it's a little bit not a natural move for the industry to develop such things. And I think that's the reason why, with open eyes, we believe that somebody should have act, and that's what we have been doing. The question of quality is key. I think you mentioned the reality we are facing. I think that I was in the same room with some of you before talking about access and the roadmap from WHO, but I think that the quality of the medicines that the people are, in most of the cases, paying themselves is really bad. And I think that there is not sufficient attention, and I think that the global community, together with the country, needs to find a way to better increase that situation, because everything that we have been doing it will fail if it's not delivered appropriately. I have the privilege to have tasted the new formulation, and it's very good. So I believe that so we are expecting the registration. But more seriously, I think that it will be a game changer, frankly. We are waiting for that. We have been following all the challenge. And really, when we say it's not easy to develop pediatric formulation, I think that it was maybe the worst situation and the worst product to face. But I think they are getting there. I think that one of the challenges will be, and that's a discussion we have with the Global Fund, but also with PEPFAR, to make sure that, let's say, the detection, and we have invested also, I will come to that in terms of diagnostic, because also diagnostic is specific for the children, in particular for HIV, will match with the procurement. As you know, we have organized with the Global Fund, with a lot of you, the procurement mechanism. It was at the beginning set for pediatric formulation. Now it's a little broader. It's the kind of mechanism that will help to realize the uptake. So with all the partners, but with DNDi and the Global Fund and PEPFAR, we are really thinking that next year, at least, we will have a formulation that can take care of the kids that are at least 3 kilos. TB, I mean, TB is a very good example where we went to WHO and say, well, we believe that there is an issue also in TB for the pediatric. And we have been working with them, with expert group of WHO to set what kind of formulation, what kind of dosage we should for. It was 60 years after the development of the TB drugs, but none for the children. Which, again, it's when you say market shortcomings, it's a clear example. So we have been working with TB Alliance on that, and they succeed and to have the right formulation, and for the situation now. First, the epidemiology have changed. It's also an outcome. When we start, it was 500,000 of children, and people told us, but why you care? It's so few children. But we say, well, 500,000 is already something that somebody should address. But in fact, it turns that when you have the formulation now, it's 79 countries that can have access to that formulation. But it has been delivered in the 590,000. And we know from WHO that, in fact, it's more than 1 million of children each year that are in need of treatment. So the fact that we create solution offer the opportunity to take care of the kids. Also, it's a lesson learned of this specific activities. Another example, and it's one I like a lot, and thanks to MMV to have been working on the formulation, the new formulation, because it's not sometimes new drugs, it's also to have the right formulation, in that case to have a better adapted formulation for children with the better taste, easy to use. And we had other things that we have been doing and we will do in the future with MMV. But what I like in this story is that the fact that seasonal chemoprophylaxis is very specific. It has been invented with Institut de la Recherche et Développement in Senegal, with Senegalese, extended to Mali. We had clinical trials that leads to a recommendation for WHO in 2012, but no use. So we issue a call. We have been working with Malaria Consortium and MMV to develop the right formulation because the drugs were bad at that time, and we organized the market. The outcome after 3 seasons is that a reduction in malaria case at the level of the clinical trial, so it efficacy around 80%. Decreased by 10 million of cases of malaria and save 60,000 of kids. With a coverage, we end the project last year around 25 to 40%. But this year, with the support of Global Fund, with the support of PMI, we end the country because the country likes it, because they can see that the kids are not sick during the malaria season, and also it has positive effect. That, in fact, we are now reaching a coverage by 60% of the population of kids. And it's something that, when we talk about scaling up, the fact that we need, of course, the Global Fund, we need the countries and also the US bilaterals to take at another level, of course, we can expect even better results. We had a lot of investment also in MMV pushing the artesunate injectable, but also the rectal artesunate in case of the kids cannot reach the higher level of quality of service and in between. So it's something that we are working. But for us, what we what we think is with a more portfolio approach is the really the question of coverage, is how can we make sure that when the product is available, it can reach all the people in need. One key element also, I mentioned it before, is the question of diagnostic. We have invested a lot on that. We have, thanks to Gélise, who is in this room, demonstrate that point of care, early infant diagnostic, has a real superiority in terms of taking care of the kids, because the central system can produce a result, but they produce a result 2 months or 3 months or even longer. So, of course, the kid and the mother will not stay in health. EID is very important. Also, we are working with University of Bordeaux in terms of how to increase the detection of TB among children. As you know, they don't have the sputum, so it's a very specific situation. So we believe that even using also point of care with techniques, we can increase the ratio of detection, which is a challenge for all the kids at risk of TB, but in particular the kids with living with HIV. So this is the sort of comprehensive way that we are looking for the specific issue of pediatric medicines. Again, I think that what we have invested is quite a lot. It's around $800 million over the last 10 years. But what is more important for us is the impact and the coverage that we are looking for all the projects we are funding. Thank you.
Thank you very much.